start to look at the total picture, everybody's been waiting for a correction. They've been talking about a correction, how we should have a correction. The only missing piece of that puzzle is, why should we have a correction?
What about earnings? What about earnings?
Are earnings bad?
Well,
no. Are earnings up?
There's some growth, but it's not as much as some would like.
But, you know, it's going to be hard to grow earnings. It's going to be hard to grow revenues in an economy like this. Until Washington actually figures out that they're not controlling the situation, that business is, and once they understand that, business will get back to hiring, building, doing things to increase their top line and bring more money to the bottom line. Right now, you're stuck because we don't know what health care is going to cost. We don't know what the taxes are going to be. We don't know what the regulations are going to be. So we can't spend the money. So growth here is going to be anemic.
We talked to you a couple months ago, and you were playing the recovery in the housing market. There were
Yes.
a number of housing-related stocks you liked. Is that still one of the best bets, do you think, or is that played out?
Very much so. I mean, if you look at the housing numbers and the housing companies came out just the other day, and they're saying, well, we just don't see a huge rosy picture in the future. Interesting enough, that's not where you want to play. I mean, if you think pork's going to go up, most people would think of buying the pig. You're better off buying the food for the pig. Then you don't have the overhead, right? Same thing with the housing. You could buy the new builders, but the new builders are still going to use a Mohawk or a Beacon Roofing or appliances from Whirlpool. The play isn't in the new housing companies. What it is the ancillary businesses, because people in America have deferred maintenance on their house for the last 4 to 5 years. Now it's time to put in some carpet, cabinetry, maybe patch the roof, do things, and that's where you're going to make the money.
What other sectors in the U.S. do you like?
You know, there's value through all sectors right now. The only sector that I'm not really hot on, haven't been hot on, is really technology. Simply because I don't see anything in the future that's going to change the way you and I work and live. The PC did that in the 70s. The internet did it in the 90s. I just don't see anything out there right now that's going to change the way you and I work and
live.
It's
interesting in light of Apple's recent stock slide. I guess it's telling.
Well, Apple, you could see that coming. And I was telling people, when you look at Apple, they were great at taking existing technology and putting it into a product with the concept you can't live without it. And people believe that, and they believe, I have to have that. Well, how much more do you need on an iPhone now? I mean, really think about it. It does everything for you, so people are gonna keep their iPhones, not 6 months, they're gonna keep it for a year, 2 or 3 years. It's a different ballgame.